So I found another hut in the early part of the game, and I have decided, because remember, I get to pick. Now, I can't pick the same thing too quickly in a row. That's kind of the way it works. Like, once you find something and pick it, you can't pick from that same class of things until you find, I believe, two more intervening huts. Granted, now that Civ 6 is out, you guys probably don't care about the details of how Civ 5 worked, but I've decided what to pick here, and while you might say, oh, I should get the technology, I'm doing fine on technology. I'll develop it fast enough on my own. But you'll notice that my capital is not growing right now because I'm building a very early settler. So I'm going to take additional population. Give myself one heck of a big city early on. That's going to actually speed up probably this. Oh, look, my borders are expanding. Yeah, everything's coming up Millhouse here. So I've explored my region. I haven't explored up here yet. I think there's probably more land up this way. This might be an inland sea. I can't quite tell. Of course, it looks like water comes around that way. So it's shaping up to where I'll probably try to build a city like up here somewhere. And I'll probably try to build a city like right here to get in his biz. I really want the city over here because I want to get these citrus and I want to just completely kind of wall off Persepolis because I gotta eliminate at least one player. Like, there's all humans here. I gotta make sure that I don't get blindsided. So I think I'm gonna get this settler out because, like, one, two, three. So one, two, three. I might actually build the city right here because that'll get me the salt, which I don't have access to, which means I'll have the extra luxury resource that I need to justify founding the city. So I'll get a water access. I'll be able to build river stuff. I'll have some fish. I'll have even more copper. I'll have all the copper in the world. I won't be next to a mountain. And being next to a mountain would actually be pretty useful in terms of building stuff later, but my choice is because I could go here just the same. Because I'll have plenty of copper, so being on this, losing the mine wouldn't be so bad. Going here would actually block this off even more effectively. And it would let me build an observatory later, and some wonders that require that. And it would encroach pretty nicely, but I think I want the ocean access. I've been playing the civilization, one easy failing is to not have enough ocean access, and you'll have to basically conquer someone's ocean access and get it. So I think I'm gonna build my city here immediately, and then I'm gonna move my little military up over here to Menace, and I'm gonna try to sneak in. If I can get another settlement over here, making this whole swatch mine, then I'm in real good shape. Dangerously good shape. Now up here, I'll probably build a fort and, like, keep a guy there just to kind of keep this off, because this is a very nice defensive area. It'll really constrain where war can happen. But depends on what's up here. Probably build a city. So I'll build a city somewhere up here. Really, I might send a military unit, like a scout or something. I might build one really quick. Send it up here to make sure that I kind of don't want Persepolis to be able to settle here or here. So I gotta keep military units around to menace. And frankly, I think I should be aggressive. I'll probably declare war if I cannot come to some sort of accord to prevent them from settling near me. They can settle all they want up here. Don't really care. But I'm taking all this biz. My empire expands at the expense of Persepolis. I'm going to surround Persepolis with cities like an amoeba, and eventually Persepolis will itself be mine. We will, unfortunately, Craig and Oliver, not be friends because I do not have enough room to settle here on my own. I have a nice buffer in that no one can invade me from this side for some time. Look at this. I've actually got this triad of city-states. And the land seems to dead end at all three, and I suspect the bottom of the map is right down here. That's my guess. Especially because I see this tundra creeping in. So there's no civilizations anywhere but up this way. Maybe on the other side of these guys, but again, nice buffer. So I'm gonna get a city here, and then hopefully also sneak a city around over here. I might rush another settler. So first things first, I should continue down my liberty path to rush that settler. And also increase my production a little bit. So, I could build the city here or here. It's an interesting question. They're both great spots, actually. In a vacuum, I would prefer to build it on this hill, which would also get me access to that copper. But if I build it here, I get access to the same resources, because look, this guy can still get to that salt and all this stuff. I'd rather be a little closer to my own biz, because if I'm here, he could theoretically surround the city and cut me off in a war. I know there's going to be a war. This is more defensible. The city will be able to plug this gap. Now, why don't I build it in the gap? Well, I want to be on this river here. I want to be far enough away from my stuff so I'm not overlapping too heavily. And if I build it like up here, well, it'd be next to the mountain, that'd be nice. I wouldn't be able to actually build the mine on top of this. I would get the resource, but I wouldn't get the benefit of the mine. So all things considered, I think I want to build the city here. Now, normally, I build a monument first thing when I build a city like this. But a lot of the reason I do that isn't so much to buff this culture, but to make sure that the city's borders expand quickly. But the borders are already pretty nicely expanded here. Not as big as I would have hoped, actually. I was kind of hoping they'd be bigger. But can't really predict what the logic is for these guys. So I build the monument. Do I build another military right away? Do I go for early religion? Because early religion could actually be useful too. No one's going to bother me anytime soon, militarily. I get away. I'll build some walls here soonish. I think I'm going to go with the monument, actually. Let's push culture first. Now that the city is secure. Now this guy might come and menace. I'm going to come back around here and be ready to counter menace.